The Romanov family was the last imperial dynasty to rule Russia. They first came to power in 1613, and over the next three centuries, 18 Romanovs took the Russian throne, including Peter the Great, Catherine the Great, Alexander I, and Nicholas II. During the Russian Revolution of 1917, Bolshevik revolutionaries toppled the monarchy, ending the Romanov dynasty. Tsar Nicholas II and his entire family, including his young children, were later executed by Bolshevik troops. The Romanovs were high-ranking aristocrats in Russia during the 16th and 17th centuries. In 1613, Mikhail Romanov became the first Romanov Tsar of Russia, following a 15-year period of political upheaval after the fall of Russia's medieval Rurik dynasty. He took the name Michael I. Michael I's grandson Peter I, also known as Peter the Great, transformed Russia from a landlocked state into one of Europe's largest empires. Through wars against the Ottoman Empire and the Empire of Sweden, Russia expanded its territory and became the dominant power in both the Baltic and Black Sea regions. Peter I declared himself Emperor of the newly formed Russian Empire in 1721, a position he held until his death in 1725. The Russian Imperial Romanov family, Emperor Nicholas II, his wife Empress Alexandra and their five children, Olga, Tatiana, Maria, Anastasia, and Alexei, were shot and bayoneted to death by Bolshevik revolutionaries under Yakov Yurovsky on the orders of the Euro-Regional Soviet in Yekaterinburg on the night of 17 July 1918. The family was ordered to dress and go down to the cellar of the Ipatyev house, where they were lined up as if posing for a family photograph. There they were shot by firing squad and bayoneted to death by Bolshevik troops. Also murdered that night were retainers who had accompanied them, notably Eugene Botkin, Anna Demidova, Alexei Trupp and Ivan Karatanov. The bodies were taken to the Koptiaki forest, where they were stripped, buried and mutilated with grenades to prevent identification. In 1919, the White Army commissioned an investigation, but were unable to find the unmarked grave site. The investigator concluded that the imperial family's remains had been cremated at the mineshaft called Glanina Yama, since evidence of fire was found there. In 1979 and 2007, the remains of the bodies were found in two unmarked graves in a field called Porozhenkov Log. DNA analysis confirmed the identity of Romanov family members. The last two children were not identified until they were found in the second grave in 2007. According to the official state version of the USSR, former Tsar Nicholas Romanov, along with members of his family and retinue, was executed by firing squad, by order of the Euro-Regional Soviet, due to the threat of the city being occupied by whites. Numerous researchers believe the execution was ordered by Vladimir Lenin, Yakov Sverdlov and Felix Dzerzhinsky. Following the February Revolution in 1917, the Romanov family and their servants had been imprisoned in the Alexander Palace before being moved to Tobolsk, Siberia. They were next moved to a house in Yekaterinburg, near the Ural Mountains. They were murdered in July 1918, allegedly at the express command of Lenin. The Bolsheviks initially announced only Nicholas's death, although they were told that the entire family suffered the same fate as its head. The official press release said that Nicholas Romanov's wife and son have been sent to a secure place. For over 8 years, the Soviet leadership maintained a systematic web of disinformation as to the fate of the family. From claiming in September 1919 that they were murdered by left-wing revolutionaries to denying outright in April 1922 that they were dead. The Soviets finally acknowledged the murders in 1926, following the publication in France of a 1919 investigation by white émigrés, but said that the bodies were destroyed and that Lenin's cabinet was not responsible. The Soviet cover-up of the murders fueled rumors of survivors. Various Romanov imposters claimed to be one of the children, which drew media attention away from activities of Soviet Russia. The burial site was discovered in 1979 by Alexander Avdanin, an amateur sleuth. The Soviet Union did not acknowledge the existence of these remains publicly until 1989, during the Glasnost period. The identity of the remains was later confirmed by forensic and DNA analysis and investigation, with the assistance of British experts. In 1998, 80 years after the executions, the remains of the Romanov family were reinterred in a state funeral in the Peter and Paul Cathedral in St. Petersburg. The funeral was not attended by key members of the Russian Orthodox Church, who disputed the authenticity of the remains. In 2007, a second, smaller grave, containing the remains of two Romanov children missing from the larger grave, a boy and a girl, was discovered by amateur archaeologists. However, their remains are kept in a state repository pending further DNA tests. The remains of Alexei and a sister have been confirmed by DNA analysis, but the government was allowing the church to hold Alexei's remains for additional testing. In 2008, after considerable and protracted legal wrangling, the Russian Prosecutor General's office rehabilitated the Romanov family as victims of political repressions. A criminal case was opened by the post-Soviet government in 1993, but nobody was prosecuted on the basis that the perpetrators were dead. The execution order to the government in Moscow, specifically Sverdlov and Lenin, who wanted to prevent the rescue of the imperial family by the approaching Czechoslovak Legion during the ongoing Russian Civil War. An investigation led by Vladimir Solovyov concluded in 2011 that, despite the opening of state archives in the post-Soviet years, no written document has been found that indicates that either Lenin or Sverdlov instigated the orders. However, they did endorse the murders after they occurred. Other sources argue that Lenin and the Central Soviet government had wanted to conduct a trial of the Romanovs, with Trotsky serving as prosecutor, but that the local Ural Soviet, under pressure from left SRS and anarchists, undertook the executions on their own initiative due to the approach of the Czechoslovaks. Lenin had close control over the Romanovs, although he ensured his name was not associated with their fate in any official documents. The executioners were Yakov Yurovsky, Grigory Pinakulin, Mikhail Medvedev, Peter Ermakov, Stepan Vaganov, Alexei G. Kabanov, Pavel Medvedev, Vienna Trebin, and Y.M. Tsulms. Philip Galashiokin, a close associate of Yakov Sverdlov, being a military commissar of the Uralisplcom in Yekaterinburg, however did not actually participate, and two or three guards refused to take part. Pyotr Voykov was given the specific task of arranging for the disposal of their remains. obtaining 570 liters of gasoline and 180 kilograms of sulfuric acid, the latter from the Yekaterinburg pharmacy. He was a witness but later claimed to have taken part in the murders, looting belongings from a dead Grand Duchess. After the killings, he was to declare that the world will never know what we did with them. Voykov served as Soviet ambassador to Poland in 1924, where he was assassinated by Russian monarchists in July 1927. Early the next morning, when rumors spread in Yekaterinburg about the disposal site, Yurovsky removed the bodies and hid them elsewhere. When the vehicle carrying the bodies broke down on the way to the next chosen site, Yurovsky made new arrangements and buried most of the acid-covered bodies in a pit sealed and concealed with rubble, covered over with railroad ties, and then earth on Koptyaki Road, a cart track 19 kilometers north of Yekaterinburg. On the afternoon of the 19th of July, Philip Goloshyokin announced at the Opera House on Glavny Prospect that Nicholas the Bloody had been shot and his family taken to another place. Sverdlov granted permission for the local paper in Yekaterinburg to publish the execution of Nicholas, the bloody crowned murderer, shot without bourgeois formalities, but in accordance with our new democratic principles, along with the coda that the wife and son of Nicholas Romanov have been sent to a safe place. An official announcement appeared in the national press 2 days later. It reported that the monarch had been executed on the order of Yuri Lispelkom under pressure posed by the approach of the Czechoslovaks. Over the course of 84 days after the Yekaterinburg murders, 27 more friends and relatives were murdered by the Bolsheviks. At Alepaevsk on the 18th of July, Perm on the 4th of September, and the Peter and Paul Fortress on the 24th of January 1919. Unlike the imperial family, the bodies at Alepaevsk and Perm were recovered by the White Army in October 1918 and May 1919 respectively. However, only the final resting places of Grand Duchess Elizabeth Feodorovna and her faithful companion sister Varvara Yakovleva are known today. Buried alongside each other in the Church of Mary Magdalene in Jerusalem. On the 15th of August 2000, the Russian Orthodox Church announced the canonization of the family for their humbleness, patience and meanness. However, reflecting the intense debate preceding the issue, the bishops did not proclaim the Romanovs as martyrs, but passion bearers instead. Over the years 2000 to 2003, the Church of All Saints, Yekaterinburg was built on the site of Ipatiev House. On the 1st of October 2008, the Supreme Court of the Russian Federation ruled that Nicholas II and his family were victims of political repression and rehabilitated them. The rehabilitation was denounced by the Communist Party of the Russian Federation, vowing the decision will sooner or later be corrected. On Thursday, the 26th of August 2010, a Russian court ordered prosecutors to reopen an investigation into the murder of Tsar Nicholas II and his family. Although the Bolsheviks believed to have shot them in 1918 had died long before, the Russian Prosecutor General's main investigative unit said it had formally closed a criminal investigation into the killing of Nicholas because too much time had elapsed since the crime and because those responsible had died. Moscow's Basmanny court ordered the reopening of the case, saying that a Supreme Court ruling blaming the state for the killings made the deaths of the actual gunmen irrelevant. Thank you for watching Death Row.